When the condition of Earth became severely worse due to overpopulation, NASA started farming algae on Mars. Gradually, Mars started becoming more suitable for human habitation, but the oxygen levels in Mars's atmosphere were declining. All the algae were depleted too. So, NASA sent a team of astronauts to monitor the situation near Mars. Jane, an astronaut, was chosen as the leader for this mission. Jane and her team embarked on their journey towards Mars, aiming to reach its surface in 180 days. NASA had established its headquarters on Mars, equipped with facilities for a 2-year stay. Along with them, an AI robot named Emmy was also part of the mission. Emmy's task was to collect samples from the Martian surface and transmit information back to Earth. As they prepared to land on Mars, their spaceship was hit by a powerful solar flare, causing many systems to fail. This made it difficult for the crew to land safely. Jane instructed her crew to evacuate while she stayed behind to fix the spaceship. Despite the challenges, Jane managed to guide her crew to the Martian surface. However, they landed at a different location than planned due to high velocity while landing. They had already dropped robot Emmy, and after some time, it activated. Meanwhile, the other crew members experienced a crash landing. Despite these challenges, when they emerged, they found that one of their team members, Bud, was severely injured. Sadly, Bud won't be able to continue with them due to his injuries. Jane, who was on the spaceship, faced many personal struggles. Despite a major explosion hitting the spaceship, Jane remained calm. She had encountered such challenges throughout her career. Escaping the fire and explosion, she ventured out of the spaceship. Meanwhile, the crew members who had landed on Earth were unable to locate their headquarters. They might have to trek there, leaving behind Bud due to his injury. Bud's lifelong dream was to set foot on Mars, so he requested his team to bring back a stone from Mars for his daughter. Tragically, Bud's breath faded away in the next moment. The team acknowledged his wish and pressed on with their journey. On the spaceship, Jane grappled with the absence of signals from her fellow crew members. Despite repeated attempts, she couldn't establish communication. Meanwhile, on the Martian surface, the four astronauts tirelessly searched for their headquarters. After a long search, they finally stumbled upon it, only to find it completely destroyed. The four astronauts were surprised to see what happened. Their base on Mars was designed to withstand any storms, so they never expected it to break so easily. This meant they were left with limited resources to survive on Mars. They had been doing research at this base for about 2 years, but now they wouldn't be able to continue. When Jane couldn't get signals from the others, she sent reports to the space station orbiting Earth. However, Jane didn't realize the danger her crewmates were facing. As time passed, Mars became colder. The four astronauts had only 1 hour of oxygen left, and they were starting to panic. It had taken 20 years to plan this mission, and now it seemed like it might all be wasted. Meanwhile, two astronauts named Robbie and Bob, who both liked Jane, were chatting as they wandered into a mountainous area. The debate between Robbie and Bob began, but then Robbie accidentally hit Bob, causing him to fall down the hill and meet a painful death. When Robbie joined his other astronaut friends, he made up an excuse, saying that Bob was deeply depressed and had committed suicide. However, the other team members knew Bob well and didn't believe Robbie's story because Bob would never take his own life. Unfortunately, Robbie's oxygen supply ran out, causing everyone to struggle to breathe. As they all fell to the ground and suffered, Robbie opened his helmet slightly and took a breath, revealing that he could breathe in Mars's environment. Now, Robbie asks his teammates to remove their helmets too. None of them understood how they could breathe on Mars since the oxygen there had run out. Then, Jane received a signal from Earth's space station, instructing her to finish her mission quickly and return. Even if the other astronauts on Mars wanted to return to the spaceship, they couldn't. Robbie and the others began to feel very cold in the Martian environment without any equipment to keep warm. However, their troubles weren't over yet. Soon, they encountered their AI robot, Emmy, who began attacking them without reason. Emmy's systems had been damaged during the crash landing, causing it to attack anything it perceived as alive. Some of Robbie's friends were injured, but they managed to find a safe hiding spot and escape Emmy's assault. After a while, Robbie told his team members that back in 1998, NASA had dispatched a rescue rover to Mars. He mentioned that if they could locate it, they might be able to return to their spaceship. However, finding the rover wasn't going to be easy. Despite this challenge, they decided to embark on their journey without dwelling too much on the difficulties. During their journey, Robbie and the other astronauts stumbled upon a small rover that had been sent to orbit Mars long ago. Despite its non-functioning state, they began repairing it using some of the equipment on board. By utilizing the devices inside, they managed to transmit a radio signal back to Jane. Their plan succeeded, and Jane learned that the astronauts were still alive. She relayed this information to the space station orbiting Earth. However, there was a clear directive from Earth. If the astronauts failed to locate the Russian rescue rover within 24 hours and reach the spaceship, Jane would have to return alone. Now, Robbie has decided to continue with his other friends. However, they've lost all hope and didn't believe they could reach the rescue rover. Despite this, they have no other choice, so they all begin moving toward the rover. Meanwhile, they learn from Jane that only two people can fit in the rover. This means one of the three of them will have to sacrifice their life. On their journey, they encounter a severe storm and are also attacked by the robot Emmy. Somehow, they manage to find shelter in a nearby cave. However, Robbie suddenly feels compelled to act very kindly. He urges his other two friends to leave with the help of the rover. This action raises suspicion from an astronaut named Chip, who believes Robbie may be trying to deceive them. Without informing the others, Chip rushes towards the rover with the intention of being the only one to board the spaceship. Ben was looking at his handheld screen and saw that an out-of-control Emmy was heading towards astronaut Chip. Suddenly, a robot attacked Chip and killed him. Ben and Robbie had no control over these events. They forgot everything and rushed towards the rover. Along the way, they stumbled upon an area covered in algae, which surprised them because algae was supposed to be absent from the rest of Mars. They couldn't understand why algae remained in this particular place. Their confusion deepened when they found Chip dead in the same location. Ben decided to extract the oxygen tank from Chip's suit so they could use it. Using an oxygen cutter, Ben attempted to cut open Chip's suit, but to their shock, small fireballs started emerging from Chip's body. They soon realized the dark secret of Mars. These fireballs were actually advanced insects that were consuming everything, including Chip. Ben, being a microbiologist as well as an astronaut, began to examine these insects closely. Actually, all these insects were present on Mars for years, but when we humans planted algae on Mars and tried to change the environment here, then these insects started eating the algae continuously. And these insects had also completely destroyed their headquarters. Although Ben finds out one more thing that these insects, even though they ate the algae, but the waste product that came out of their bodies, along with that, they also released a lot of oxygen. And that was the reason why they were able to breathe in the Mars environment. That means all these insects can prove to be very beneficial for them. So Ben collects the sample of these insects with him. But now a group of these insects had started climbing on Ben's body continuously. Ben realized that he was not going to survive. That's why he gives Robbie the samples and makes himself explode by burning himself with fire. Because of which, many insects died due to burning, and now Robbie was completely alone on Mars. Robbie connects with Jane and shares everything with her. Robbie feels sad and loses hope of escaping from where they are, but Jane encourages him to keep going. Because of Jane's encouragement, Robbie decides to keep moving forward. He quickly reaches a rescue rover. Jane guides Robbie on how to repair the rover, but Robbie realizes that it doesn't have enough power to take him to Mars because it lacks a battery. Without batteries, Robbie can't even reach Mars's orbit. Feeling defeated, Robbie gives up completely. After 24 hours, Jane's spaceship automatically leaves Mars's orbit and starts heading towards Earth. Robbie is now stranded on Mars's surface, but luck wanted something else. Now Robbie had Emmy with him. Then Robbie deactivated the robot by short circuit. Robbie then takes out all the batteries from Emmy and places them in different parts of the rover. Now, Robbie's rover had a lot of power, enough to reach the orbit of Mars. So, Robbie wasted no time and began his journey toward Mars's orbit. He also contacted Jane to let her know about himself. Even though Jane's spaceship had already departed, she still strapped wire tubes to her body and ventured into space to rescue Robbie. Jane successfully caught Robbie's rover, and together they headed towards her spaceship. Upon safely reaching the spaceship, Robbie and Jane hugged each other. Robbie also had samples of various insects with him, so they weren't returning to Earth empty-handed. It seemed like Jane might have feelings for Robbie as well, but she was unaware of his darker side. And with this, our story comes to an end. If you enjoyed my recap even a little bit, please like and subscribe to the channel.